Hey friends, Isaac here. It's Tuesday, November 9th. Welcome to the Living the Dream Show with Kevin White. This is the podcast where we live the dream of people of every nation,
tribe and tongue,
worship Jesus together on earth today
as it already is in heaven.
Thank you for subscribing, reviewing and sharing the show. Kevin's newest book, Get to the Point, was an instant international bestseller. Get to the Point is available worldwide in paperback,
hardback, ebook,
and audiobook.
It is a practical guide for passionately pursuing God's presence. Every guidance and provision you will ever need can be found today in the presence of God. Visit kevinwhite.us to read and gift Get to the Point and Kevin's first book, Audacious Generosity, today. Today, Kevin is joined by Temsala Bass of Nashville, North Carolina. Temsala is a sister in Christ, friend and board member for Global Hope India. Put your hands together and let's welcome Kevin and Temsala to today's show.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the show. I am Kevin White, and I am with my friend, Dr. James Jurgen of the Cornerstone Chiropractic Center in Cary, North Carolina. My brother in Christ, how are you? Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me. I was like just about to finish it. I'm so excited to dive into your book. I'm so excited to be able to share this news with everyone listening today.
Yeah, it's November the 9th, and Get to the Point, the latest book God has put on my heart to publish, is now available worldwide on Amazon and at kevinwhite.us. And I can't wait to encourage everyone to share, review, and gift Get to the Point.
You know, anything that you do, and this is me speaking from my heart, anything that you do, even if I didn't see it, even if I didn't know about it, and you told me about it, I would share it with everybody I know because I know who you are and I know your heart. I hope that every single person out here, they actually get your book, they share your book, and even more important than that, they dive into your book. Mm-hmm. Because if you miss this, you miss literally everything else in this life. And I say that with complete honesty, getting to the point is the thing that we absolutely need the most. Yeah. And until we do, we're going to be chasing down a lot of other things in this life that don't matter. Mm-hmm. We're going to be chasing down maybe good things, but with emptiness. Mm-hmm. And until we get to the point, until we as Christians, as we get to the point, the world will always rebuke us and the world will always turn us away because they don't know that we have the answer that they're looking for. This world is desperately crying out for love. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at it, it's all around us, but because it's not founded in truth, there's all of these other interpretations and all of these things, but we have God's presence. They're literally longing for it. They're crying out for it. And they don't know that we have a loving God who wants to pursue them, who wants to be in your presence. He wants you to be in his presence and him to be in your presence and share that moment, that precious moment that we have every single moment of every single day, this life that we have. And until you read this book, until you meditate through this book, until you read it, you're really, it's just one of those things that you're going to be chasing a lot of the wrong things. Mm-hmm. And I can say that because on one of our early episodes, I said this, and I don't want to say it so many times that we brush through it without meaning of these words, but if I were to put a percentage of how many believers actually have a deep and personal relationship with God, maybe it's 2%. Mm. I don't know. I think that we have this world around us, but then also this family within Christians, you know, our Christ family, like we're longing for his presence. Some don't know how to access his presence or don't even know that we can access his presence, but this book is revolutionary and it's going to change so many people's lives. Let it change your life.
Well, I'm very humbled by your comments there, and I'm so grateful for the great reviews that God has given. I know that this is a great word from God. It truly bore witness in my life and incredible fruit in my life. It wasn't until I was 30 years old that I began to get to the point. I'm a very stiff-necked, hard-hearted person, and God had to fly me 8,000 miles away to India. I'd been working here as a workaholic for God to a point that a church literally dismissed me as pastor, not because of any misappropriation of fun or sexual immorality, but because I was just a deranged workaholic and I could never get enough success. And I had to keep building more and more and more on it. And they didn't know what to do to the point that they dismissed me as pastor. And then God flew me 8,000 miles away and put me in a thatch roof hut in the middle of India with no Bibles, no budgets, no bulletins. And it was a church, and it was probably one of the most real churches I'd ever been a part of, because all they did was simply pursue the presence of God. They had no organs. They had no guitars, no flashy PowerPoint, no light show or anything, no audio system, but yet they passionately pursued the presence of God, and you could sense it. He honored their request. He honored their faith. And I came back hungry for what they had. And I remember, you just talked about this, but I remember on the plane ride back, I drew out a cross, the Holy Spirit guided me, and I put good things on the cross that I used to pursue, influence and impact for God. Those are good. There's nothing wrong with that. But on the other cross, I drew out a second cross and I just wrote presence on it. And from that day forward, I committed to passionately pursue the presence of God. And I wish I had this book decades ago, because this book is simply a practical guide for passionately pursuing the presence of God. And it is repeated and reinforced in every single chapter that every guidance and provision we will ever need can be found today in the presence of God. The whole point about getting to the point is getting into the presence of God.
You know, like that last bit that you said, how it's sprinkled through every, you know, every chapter, because it's so important. Mm-hmm. Without God's presence, you will never have enough. Mm-hmm. You'll always be longing for more. Mm-hmm. And with God's presence, you will always have more than enough. Mm-hmm. Right? I mean, we talked about the fruits of the Spirit on the last episode, and if we are outside of his presence, we're going to be longing for all of those things. We're going to be longing for his fruit. We're going to be longing for those things. And in his presence, we have access to all of it. Mm-hmm. And then you realize that when you're in his presence, the only thing that really matters is that moment. Mm-hmm. And being with him. And then from that full cup, you're going to look around at this world with a whole new set of lenses. And you're going to start to see this world as hurting, as truly needing God's love. You're going to start to see God's people through a new lens. You're going to start to see them as valuable, as how much they truly matter, and how a lot of the actions that they're doing are from this place of not having what they need. Mm-hmm. And what they need is God's presence, because when they're in God's presence, then they have all that they need. Mm-hmm. Outside of their presence, they're going to be hurting. And us too, if we're not in God's presence, that's when we hurt others. That's when we become selfish. That's when we have all of those things that we are trying to fill. And so we try to take, but in God's presence, we become generous. In God's presence, we become whole. And in God's presence, we become his love.
Yeah. Yeah. God had me declare for someone, for many people, that in his presence, the evidence of being in his presence is clarity and rest. If we think it is 2021, and if we just think about the status of mankind today on planet Earth, those are two elements that unfortunately are missing radically in our society: clarity and rest. And the evidence of being in God's presence is clarity and rest. And the greatest thing we can ever do to help others get to the point is by getting to the point ourselves. We'll never lead people further than where we go. And so the greatest thing I can do as a minister of the gospel to finish the task of the Great Commission is to get to the point, because every guidance and provision we'll ever need is found today. And I have more boldness, I have more confidence, I have more clarity, more rest, more provision than ever before in my life. And it has everything to do with the presence of God and his desire to fulfill the Great Commission in our lives.
Let's rewind to 2020 or 2019. Mm-hmm. We're ending the year. And I remember every single person, 2020 vision, more clarity in our life. They're literally, what were people asking for? 2020 vision. They were looking for clarity. They were looking to slow down. Mm-hmm. I wish I had more time. And then guess what we got? Mm-hmm. we got an opportunity to become very clear with what we want in this life, mm-hmm. to be able to slow down, to be able to be in our house, be with our family. And guess what never changed? The presence of God. And so what are people still longing for? Probably even more so now. Yeah. They're longing for more clarity. They're longing for more rest. Like, it's so crazy how, you know, we're always thinking about other times in our life, like in the past. Oh, in the good old days. Mm-hmm. Well, in the good old days, you were talking about the good old days of the past prior to that. Mm-hmm. In the good old days, you were worrying about your finances, or you were worrying about this next thing that you had to do. And we literally have this opportunity, submerged in God's presence, to have access to something that a global consciousness was asking for, which was clarity and rest. Mm-hmm. And now that we have that opportunity to slow down, we can read this book, we can dive into this book, and we can really start to come together as a family in God's presence.
Yes. Yes. Amen. Amen. Well, I could talk about the book all day long, but we're going to close out the episode. And I just want to make sure that everyone understands that it is available right now in paperback, hardback, ebook, and audiobook worldwide on Amazon. It's available in every place that you can find an ebook, over 40 different stores online, as well as audiobooks around the world. And so you can go to kevinwhite.us and you can buy all four formats right now. But I just have this vision, Dr. James, that I really believe God is going to fulfill, that I've made a matter of prayer. And that is a vision of people not just buying a book, but buying cases of it. Because I really believe that as you get to the point, you are going to want to help as many people as possible get to the point. And I'm just envisioning cases being sold and cases being shipped out and distributed, not for my gain, but for the advancement of the gospel for more and more people. Just imagine a world where everyone was dwelling in the presence of God. The Bible never promises that everyone will dwell in the presence of God, but it does say that the end will not come until the good news of the presence of God has been preached into every nation. And so the good news is best demonstrated as we all get to the point. And so I just encourage everyone, go to kevinwhite.us, share the book, review the book. One of the greatest things that you can do to help others get to the point is just review it. Review it on Amazon is a great place to review it. There, you can do it right now as an introductory price. The ebook is 99 cents. Worldwide in all the exchanges of foreign currency. And so you can easily purchase the ebook, whether you like reading it on Kindle or not. You can also purchase the paperback and hardback, but that will give you a place to give a review as a verified purchase. And that's powerful and will be used of God to help attract other people to get to the point. And so share it, review it, and gift it. Just encourage you to give as many people a copy of Get to the Point and encourage them to get to the point. But remember, the greatest thing we'll ever do to help others get to the point is to get to the point ourselves. Don't substitute and replace this for an opportunity for you to get to the point. Make sure that that is your focus as well.
I love it. I was envisioning a world that got to the point. You know, I was envisioning a world in God's presence, and I was envisioning global consciousness of the world being, you know, filled, whole, complete in Christ. And so then I was also thinking about the individuals. You know, every single listener here, you deserve to have that gift of God's presence. You deserve it for yourself. Like, go out, read it. And like we were saying, like, read through it, meditate through it, allow it to just fill your life with so much truth, mm-hmm. and gift it. Because who else deserves this information? Every single person on this planet deserves to know that there's a creator, the creator of the universe, creator of heaven and earth, took time out of his perfect existence and all of his love and all of his knowledge. He took time out of that existence to create them. And maybe this is the first time that they ever hear it. Maybe this is the first time that they realize that they could actually have an intimate relationship with the creator who loves them with his whole heart. And so be that light for this world.
Yes.
And gift this book to them, because when they start to be set free, you're actually helping this world become closer and closer to what God has envisioned for this world.
Yes. 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 Well, thank you so much, Dr. James. Let's celebrate. Praise God. To God be the glory for this book. And I just pray that everyone will get to the point. In the name of Jesus, live long and prosper. We love you all. God bless you.
Take care.
Thank you for listening to the
Living the Dream Show with Kevin White.
Find the complete archive of all episodes at kevinwhite.us or subscribe for free through your favorite podcast player
and never miss an episode.
This program is copyright Kevin White International.
All rights reserved.
Each week we bring you a message of living the dream as people of every nation, tribe and tongue worship Jesus together on earth today.
As it already is in heaven.
Remembering the gift of God's presence through Jesus Christ is accessible to everyone. Join us again next week for Living the Dream with Kevin White.
Living the Dream with Kevin White.